Hi loves, welcome back for another video, or welcome if you're new here. If you are new, make sure to subscribe right down below and join the Curlyhairlove fam. I promise we have fun here. I make lifestyle and advice and beauty and all of those fun videos and would absolutely love to have you here and chat with you and just hang out with you. So yeah, anyway, today I am doing a what's on my iPhone, and it has been absolutely forever since I filmed one of these, and I've also had some technical issues with screen recording, so this is, I think, my fifth time recording this video, which is just a little frustrating, but we're good. I'm trying a new method now. I'm gonna record it right to my computer, so I think that should solve all of my problems. Let's cross our fingers. If you're watching this on YouTube, it worked. So let's get the basics out of the way. I have a white iPhone 6S. This is it. I think it's a 128 gigabyte memory, if I remember correctly, which sounds kind of obscene, but I use my phone to vlog, so I wanted something that had plenty of storage and I would never worry about running out of space. And honestly, I've had this phone for 2 years, I still haven't filled it, so not complaining, it's incredible. And then on my phone itself, I have a wildflower case. This is the collab with Nikki DiMartino, I believe her name is. If it's still on wildflower, I will link it down below because I absolutely love this pattern. I love the like pastel colors and the really subtle like floral print on it. I'm not even sure if you guys are gonna be able to see it with the glare from my ring light, but it's there, I promise. And I've had this case for as long as I've had my phone, and I've dropped my phone more times than I'd like to admit, and it is still in one piece. My screen is not cracked or anything crazy, so I definitely am very happy with this case and would totally recommend Wildflower to you guys. I'm not sponsored by them. I wish I was. Hi, Wildflower. I would love free cases. What's up? Anyway, I totally recommend them to you guys. I know a lot of YouTubers talk about Wildflower, but it's for good reason. They're genuinely good cases. All right, so now let's get into what's actually on my phone. I'm gonna scooch myself over a little bit here, and then I will pop the recording right here. So first of all, this is my home screen. That is my boyfriend Ken, and yes, I am totally that cheesy girlfriend to have this as my background. So yeah, when you unlock my phone, this is what you see. I will just start from the top and work my way down. So I have the phone app for obvious reasons. This is a phone. And then I have my email app, and I know I have so many emails right now. It's fine. I will clean them out, I promise. But most of them are for my one email that I get like all my stores and like coupons and things too. So I've been pretty busy starting a new job and things lately, and I just haven't been as on top of everything. So it's definitely piled up. That number is stressing me out too, and I promise it's gonna be gone soon. Then next to that, I have Facebook, again, for obvious reasons. I love to use Facebook to stay in touch with my friends and family and like college friends that have moved far away and things like that. I have my Fitness Pal, which is a great app for tracking health and fitness if you guys are into that kind of thing. This basically gives you a diary to put all of your food for the day in and your exercise and all of that good stuff. This is a really great way to track just every part of your health and fitness. You can also see your nutrition, which is really cool. So I love to, when I am actually tracking my food, get in here and look at my protein and, you know, things that you wouldn't normally think about, like vitamins and all of that. And it really just kind of makes you take a step back and think about what you're putting in your body every day and if it's actually what your body needs. And then you can also track your exercise and kind of trends over time. Long story short, this is a really cool app, and I definitely recommend it if you guys are into the health and fitness side of things. I honestly haven't used it for a while, but when I'm in my phases with it, it does really help me. And then I have Instagram, everyone's best friend. Let's be honest, we all spend plenty of time on Instagram. So shout out to Jade, since she came up first. I love this girl, and she talks everything social media and is so cute. So if you guys haven't checked out her channel, go ahead and do that. I'm literally just gonna like this photo because I love her. And then we'll move on to some quick self promo because I have to take this opportunity to do it. So this is my Instagram if you guys wanna follow me. It's just Curlyhairlove, just like my channel. And I wouldn't say that I post every day. I post fairly often. Again, I've been busy lately, so I haven't been posting as much on social media in general, but I do love sharing photos and just talking to you guys on here. I also really love doing polls on my Instagram story. So right now I don't think I have anything too crazy exciting on my story. Oh yeah, I worked from home this afternoon, so this is my one story of the day. Anyway, if you guys want to follow me on Instagram. I would appreciate that. I'd love to hang out with you guys and talk to you more on there. And then in the next row, I have a lot of self-explanatory things, but I'll go through them really quickly. So I have a utilities folder, and it just has some of the basic iPhone apps. The only one that I really use a ton in here is the clock app, because your girl needs her alarm clock in the morning to get up. And then I have my camera and my settings, which I use both often, so I like to have them here on this first page. And then I have Runkeeper, which I would open and show you guys, but it would literally show my current location. I don't think that's safe. So basically, Runkeeper is another fitness tracking app. I am definitely not a runner, don't get me wrong, but you can also track bike rides and walks and hikes, and those are really just kind of the main things that I use this app for. And then next up, I have Tumblr, which is a great app to waste a lot of time with. I also haven't been on Tumblr very often recently. I'm really not sure what's happening with some of these posts. My feed is really funny because it's like all these aesthetic things, like this girl with flowers, and then it's like these really absurd like gifs and like jokes and things. So, but that like accurately describes me as a person on the internet, so you know, whatever. If you guys want to follow me, my username is like you've never lived before, which is a very like high school kind of Tumblr name, and I think that's the last time that I changed it, so it's to be expected. But if you guys want to check out my Tumblr, it will be linked down below. I love Tumblr. I can't promise that I'll post every day on it, but I just go through phases where I'm on it all the time because it's just such a fun like place to just scroll through pretty pictures and like funny jokes and like cute dogs. Like, look at this. Oh. Okay, we need to move on. So next up, I have Duolingo, which is an awesome app to either learn a new language or kind of like sharpen your language skills. Mine is set to Spanish because I took like 4 or 5 years of Spanish growing up, but never really got to the point where I was fluent, and I kind of just dropped it after that. So I love using this app just to try to kind of like sharpen those skills and work on new vocabulary. And then next up, I have Evernote, and I absolutely love this app. I cannot recommend it enough. So these are my notebooks. Basically, it's a note-taking and productivity app, and it's just amazing, like all of the things that you can do with this. I have a YouTube one, I have one for Ned, which is the company that I work for, so I keep track of all of my work stuff in there. And then I have a personal one as well, where I keep like shopping lists and to-do lists, and this is really just where I keep like a lot of my ideas and take notes when I need to. There's a lot of different features, like you can make a little checklist or change the fonts if you really want to, the colors, like there's a lot of different things you can do with this, but it's a great way to just be productive and keep track of your life, and honestly, I cannot recommend it enough. I love Evernote, it is a lifesaver. Then next up, I have the YouTube app for obvious reasons. I love YouTube, I love watching YouTube. And my favorite thing about having the app on my phone is I can control my Chromecast on my TV in my room. That's honestly pretty much the main thing I use it for, so that I can cast videos and watch them on my TV. I have an analytics folder, and this is all YouTube analytics based. I'm definitely a social media nerd. So the first app in here I have is YouTube Studio, and this is great if you're a YouTuber and you haven't downloaded this yet. You need it, I promise. You can just get in here and see all of your analytics and how your most recent videos are doing and recent comments and all of that fun stuff. And then you have all of these options here as well. You can make like a video that's private live if you need to, or you know, change something in your description. It just gives you a lot of options and it's very easy to use. So I love having this for adjusting anything to do with my channel on the go. And honestly, I use this app a lot for just looking at my analytics because I just like to see where my channel's at and where I could do better. It's a very helpful app. If you guys are YouTubers, highly recommend it. And then next to that, I have YouTube Tracker, which is more so focused for smaller YouTubers. It is basically tracking progress towards the new monetization goals. So as you can see, it makes it very simple and visual, and you can see where you're at. So I definitely have crossed the subscriber threshold, but the watch time, not so much. So I do like to check this occasionally just to see where I'm at with my watch time. I definitely still have a long way to go, but it is motivating. I'm definitely not in YouTube for the money. I would have stopped back in February if I was. I just find this motivating because I know that my channel is growing, and I would love to eventually be a partner again, and not so much just to be like, oh well, I'm making money from YouTube. But back when I was a partner, before the program changes, any money that I made for my channel I put back into my channel, so I would love to be able to do that again. And then next up, we have Social Blade, which is another analytics app. I'll be honest, I really like Social Blade better on the computer. You still do get some of their kind of like numbers and views and things like that, so it's just another way to keep track of your progress and how your videos are doing, and it's fun to look at. And you can also look up any channel that you want to right up here. Wow, that grammar though. Search for and YouTube. Good job, Social Blade. So if I just type like Shane Dawson, for example, then you can pull up his Social Blade so you can see how many subscribers he's gaining or losing, and then you also have like all these little fun things to get into. And then last but not least, I have the Live Count Social Blade app, which just shows you a channel subscribers and kind of as it's increasing live. So if you're getting close to a milestone with your subscribers, or one of your favorite YouTubers is, or one of your friends is, you can watch the number kind of fluctuate live. So for example, here's Chris Brown's YouTube channel. I think it just loads a random one until you search for one. So, but as you can see, it just kind of tracks like by the second when subscribers are being gained. So it's kind of fun to watch if someone's close to a milestone, which is why I have this app saved. And then next to that, I have my little finance folder. I have Mint, which I would open, but then you guys would see all of my finances. We're not that close, but it's a great budgeting app. I've talked about it a lot on my channel before. I definitely recommend it if you want to get your financial life together. And then I also have the Bank of America app and the Barclay US app, because those are my two banks that I bank with. And then I have the Discover app because that's one of my credit cards, and I have Venmo to send my friends money when they buy me things, or vice versa. And then next to that, I have the Weather Channel app, again, for obvious reasons. I also like the Weather Channel app because it will send me notifications when there's going to be weather happening. So if it starts raining outside, I already know before I get outside without my umbrella and I'm sad. Then in the next row, I have a little business folder, which is not too crazy exciting. It's a very adulty kind of thing to have, but these apps at the top are just how I access my work email and calendar and everything like that. And then I also have LinkedIn in here to keep in touch with my connections, which honestly are mostly my college friends, but I do have some professional connections too. So it's fun to just kind of keep in touch with people and see what people are posting on LinkedIn. I'm such an adult, gross. Then next to that, I have TimeHop, which I'm sure most of you guys have heard of, but it is such a fun app and I cannot recommend it enough if you guys don't use it. First of all, it has this cute little dinosaur Abe, but then it will pull from your camera roll, which I have pictures of cakes from last year for some reason. And then it shows you, you know, your previous tweets and again, photos from your camera roll and Instagrams, like whatever you want to plug in, you can see all of your old posts and photos. And I'm definitely a nostalgic kind of person, so I really enjoy TimeHop and just love checking it every day. And then I also have the 5-Minute Journal app, which I love so much. It's so cute. I haven't used it for a while, as you guys can see, but I will go ahead and just show you. So you write a morning entry and you write what you're grateful for, things that you'll do to make today great, and then also a daily affirmation for yourself. And then for the evening entry, you write three amazing things that happened, and then how could I have made today even better. So it's really just about kind of taking a few minutes to be grateful and kind of just instill more positivity in your life. So I love this app. I wish that I used it more. I need to work on it, but I do really recommend it for you guys. And then last but not least, for this first page on the bottom, I have some pretty self-explanatory apps, but I'll go through them really quickly. So first, I have a little music folder. My most used app is definitely Spotify. I love my Spotify and all my playlists and all of those fun things. And can I show you my profile? Yeah, there it is. So this is my profile. If you guys really felt like following me, that'd be cool. I will try to figure out how to link it down below. I definitely love following other YouTubers on Spotify because I have pretty similar music tastes to them. My music taste is all over the place, so I guess the best way to describe it is if you guys like the music that is in my like end card, then you probably would like the music that's on my Spotify. So I will just leave it down below if you guys want to check it out. And then in this folder, I also have Pandora, SoundCloud, and the Apple Music app. I really use Spotify the most, like I said, but I also like the Apple Music app because it's all of my music like from my computer that I had saved back in the days before Spotify. So it's really fun to open that up sometimes because it's like all of my old music and I don't have it all saved on Spotify. So it's just a fun throwback sometimes. And then also SoundCloud and Pandora are fun when I want to change things up. I have Twitter, which again, pretty self-explanatory, but I really love Twitter. That's why it's on my little bottom bar so that I can access it from any screen, because I love seeing new tweets and checking out what people are up to. And I really haven't been as good about tweeting recently, but I try to post when like relevant things are going on that you guys would want to know about, or when I post a new video. But yeah, this is my Twitter if you guys want to check it out. It'll be linked down below, just like everything else. So getting into the next page, I will try to go a little quicker because I feel like I've made this video kind of long. I have a little lifestyle folder, and this just has the App Store and the iTunes Store. And then I have a travel folder, which has a ton of apps in it. So I'm not gonna go too in depth, but I have the little wallet app to save tickets and things like that too. I have Google Maps so that I don't get lost when I'm going somewhere new. And also Google Maps is very helpful if you live in a trafficy area like DC. Sometimes if I'm like driving somewhere that I've been a million times, I'll still put it in Google Maps to see what the best way to go is depending on the traffic. And then I have TripAdvisor if I ever want to look up like a restaurant or something when I'm on the go. I have Expedia to look up flights, which is very helpful. I have Geico Mobile because they're my car insurance and sometimes I need to change something or show my insurance cards. I have Parking Panda to search for parking. I know at least in the DC area, this is super helpful. So you guys should definitely check out that app if you have to park and pay for parking fairly often, which is just kind of a fact of life in this area. And I have the JetBlue app. I'm a pretty frequent JetBlue flyer. So I have that front and center because when I fly, it's very often with them. So I can have my boarding pass and everything like that ready to go. And I have a Metro app, which is awesome if you guys live in the DC area. It shows you all the buses, which really I don't take Metro buses, but it also has all of the lines. So for example, I usually take the yellow line to work and I can click on any of these stations and see what the next trains coming are. And then in the next page of this folder, I just have the Disney World app for when I go to Disney. It's been a while, sad face, love Disney. That's why I haven't deleted it because I just like to think that I'm gonna go back soon and use this app again. And then I have Gas Buddy, which is really helpful to look up gas stations and gas prices near you if you need to do that. And then All Trails is a hiking app and you can find different like national parks and things like that near you. So I love that when I'm feeling more adventurous and want to try a new hike or a walk in a park. And then I also have Park Mobile, which lets you pay parking meters and things like that from your phone, which is really helpful if you don't want to go digging for some change. And then I have Lyft, which I generally use when I need to have a ride somewhere and I can't drive myself. And I definitely love Lyft and recommend it if you guys don't use it already. And then I also have Airbnb if I want to look at some places to stay when I'm traveling. And then I also have the American Air app because when I'm not flying with JetBlue, it's pretty often that I'm flying with American. So also I can have my boarding pass and all of that good stuff. The next folder is a little editing folder. I have a ton of apps in here and I don't use all of them all the time, but I will go through the highlights for you guys of the ones that I really like. So I'm definitely basic and I love my Visco cam. It's what I use to edit pretty much all of my Instagram photos right now. So here's a bunch of photos that I have posted and not posted depending on whether it ended up working with my feed or not, because I'm one of those people. But Visco is really great. There's a lot of great filter options and different things that you can do to edit your photos. And then I also really love Unum. I'm sure that I'm not the first YouTuber to talk about it that you guys have heard from, but it's just basically an Instagram feed planning app. So you can move any of these around and just see, you know, like the way that the order that you want to post your pictures in if you're that into your Instagram. And also they have analytics if you want to really get into the nitty-gritty of things. And a really cool thing is it will tell you the best times for you to post photos based on how well your photos have done. So this is definitely getting into the more like social media nerd side of things, but it's a really cool feature that Unum has. And huge fan. And then I have a second page of the editing app. I have Airbrush to touch up little things. Like say I take a picture against a wall and there's like a smudge next to me. I just like to clean up little details like that. And then Lively is a really great app. If you take live photos on your phone, you can convert them into a video and I think even a GIF if you want to. I have Canva, which is amazing. I don't know if I'm logged in. Let's see. I'm not. Well, just kidding, because I don't want to take too much time, but Canva is a great graphic design resource. It's very easy to use, so I love having the app on my phone so that I can do quick little designs for Instagram stories or things like that. And then I have Snapseed, which is another photo editing app, and this one is so crazy robust. It's amazing. I will just pick up this picture of my friend Becky and I to show you guys. So they also have filters, which they kind of remind me more of like Lightroom presets because they have a little bit more to them built in. And then they also have all of these tools. So if you like really want to get into your photo editing, but you don't want to get into Photoshop, this is probably the best app. And I believe it was free, so it's totally worth it. And then last but not least in this folder, I have Unfold, which is a Instagram story building app. I really just use this when I want to promote my new videos, as you can see. So my favorite template to use is this one that has the horizontal photo at the top, and then I just leave the bottom one blank so that I can add text or GIFs or whatever I'm feeling. So next up, I have the little shopping folder. These are just all of my apps that I tend to shop on. So obviously. So I have Starbucks for buying coffee and getting all those rewards and things. And then I also have Panera because I go there fairly often as well. There's one pretty close to my office and you can order ahead, which is really nice. And then I have Amazon for any orders I might need to place. I have Open Table, which is a really cool app if you guys are into like making reservations before you go to restaurants. Sometimes that's needed. Then next to that, I have Award Wallet, which you can just use to track rewards programs. You can track like your credit card points and miles if you're like frequent flyer with an airline, just all of those kinds of things all in one place. So as you can tell, I like things simplified and that I can just look at, and it's just really nice to have. And then I have a games folder because I am a child at heart and love my iPhone games. Honestly, I don't play all of these all the time, but I do love to have games to just kind of pass the time. I have the NASCAR app, and many of you may not know this, but I grew up in a NASCAR family and absolutely love NASCAR and live for it. I used to religiously sit down with my family every Sunday and watch the race of the week, but now I like to have this app so that I can keep up with what's going on and how my favorite driver is doing, which is Joey Logano, in case you guys were wondering. You probably weren't, but whatever. So you can see like the schedule and the driver standings and all of that good stuff. And then next up I have Band Is In Town, which is an amazing app. If you guys love going to concerts, you need this. So it will scan all of your like music on your phone, and if you connect your Facebook, it'll add that too. And it's just amazing. It gives you notifications when artists that you like are going to have a show nearby. Then I can actually go on here and see when their next shows are. And if I wanna go see All Time Low, I can see that they're coming to Baltimore and I could go see them on Saturday, August 18th if I wanted to. That'd be pretty cool. This app is great, but also if you're prone to impulse buy tickets, I don't recommend it because you will know when all of your favorite bands are playing, and that is a quick way to drain your bank account. Then next to that, I have Pinterest, which honestly, I'm not a very avid Pinterest user. I don't even think I link it in the down bar anymore because I just don't really use it. I really just like to browse recipes on there sometimes, and I will pin those so that I can use them in the future. I have this app called Infinite Storm, which is amazing. It basically just plays the sound of a thunderstorm. And I think if I do this, you guys would actually hear it, which would be weird. But anyway, it just plays like a sound of a thunderstorm, and then you can set a timer for it to turn off. So when I'm like really restless and can't sleep, this is perfect for me. I think it's because I grew up in Florida and we have thunderstorms a lot there. That sound is just super relaxing for me, and this will put me out like a baby every single time. So I love having that app. And if you guys also find thunderstorm sounds relaxing, this is a good one. And then I have Goodreads, which I use to track books that I'm reading and books that I want to read. I have a countdown app, which just lets me count down to trips and exciting things that are coming up. I have the NBC app. I was using this a lot during the Stanley Cup, and I also watch my Chicago shows on here. So I'm super behind now though, which is sad because they took the season that I was watching off and they started posting the new season. And then in the next row, I have the Playlist Live app, which is really useful when you're at Playlist Live. It gives you the schedule and you can see just everything that is going on at Playlist. I have the podcast app, and I actually do use this probably almost every day. These are some of my favorite podcasts. I just started listening to Badass Creatives, but I really like it so far. I have the Hannah Ashton podcast. She's amazing. Hannah is adorable. I highly recommend her for you guys. I have Kayla Nicholson's podcast, the Influencer podcast, just a bunch of different ones that I like to listen to. I have Influencer, which I'm still pretty new to, but if you're an influencer, you can check it out if you want to. It's basically just like a review platform. I have Speed Test, which is another kind of like internet nerd thing, but it's really fun. So you can just turn this on and see how quickly your internet is running. So we'll do a little speed test of my internet right now. And it is at a nice almost 100 megabits per second, which I will work with because that's what we're paying for. So anyway, that's a nice app to just test the internet speed if you need to know how it's working and how fast your YouTube video is gonna upload. That's honestly why I have this. All right, guys, we made it to the last page. If you're still watching this, you're awesome because I feel like I've made it way too long. I have this little random app folder, which, you know, like the name, is just a bunch of random apps. A lot of them are ones that I cannot delete from my phone but don't use. So that is pretty much why this folder exists. And then I have Eve, which is a really awesome app if you're a gal and you want to keep track of your period. It's not a fun cycle, but knowing when it's going to come is very helpful. So not that you guys needed to know, but I'm on mine right now. And so These are all of my little cycles, and I really like that it has this calendar view and I can kind of see, you know, like when my last period was and when I might expect my next one. So this is a very useful app to have. I know there's a lot of different ones out there, but I really like this one and I've been using it for a while. I have Paymo, which is a really great app if you are a freelancer. It is kind of like a time management app, and you can track how much time you're spending working on certain projects and certain parts of projects. I haven't used it as much recently because I really haven't done as much freelance work as I used to, but it's very useful for that if you were a freelancer and just kind of need to keep track of things. I have Vimeo in case I ever need to watch anything on Vimeo on my phone. I have Bitmoji because why wouldn't you have Bitmoji? If you don't have Bitmoji, please go download it. This is mine. She's definitely my little spirit animal and I love her. Look at this Thug Life one, like, yes. In the next row, I have Bloglevin, which is one of my favorite apps. This is just a way to track all of your favorite blogs. It's kind of like Pinterest, but it's literally just a feed of blog posts. So I love this because I can see all of my favorite blogs in one place and just see their latest posts and what they're up to. And then you can also save posts. So I have all these collections of like outfits that I like and recipes I want to try and things like that. So this is a really great app and website. I definitely recommend Bloglevin and love it. I've talked about it a lot of times on my channel. Next to that, I have Freelancer, which is another great freelancer resource. Haha, get it? And I just had this so that I could message back clients and kind of see how projects were going. Again, haven't really used it recently, but it is a great resource if you're a freelancer looking for more work. I have the VidCon app, which you can see scheduling and everything like that for VidCon. I didn't even go this year, so this has been on my phone since last year, but I just don't have the heart to delete it. I love VidCon so much. I have the NBC Sports app in case I want to stream any sports games, which is fun to do sometimes. That was actually the app that I used during the Stanley Cup. I think I said the NBC app earlier, but it was this one, and that was a lot of fun to keep track of. I have Countable, which is an app that you can see what kind of issues your representative is voting on, so that's a nice app to have if you want to kind of keep track of what's going on in your area and what your politicians are up to and whether you want to vote for them next time around, because that's important to know. I have Google Earth, which is just kind of fun to look at sometimes if you want to see where in the world something is. And then I have IGTV, which is Instagram's new like video app, and I'm definitely still new to it, but I think it's really, really cool and you guys should check it out if you haven't already. You can basically see videos from anyone that you follow, and it's very interesting. It's still so new and I'm not sure how I feel about it, but I think it's really cool. And then last but not least, I have the Air Canada app because I actually just booked a flight this past weekend with my roommate Michelle to Canada so that we can go to Toronto for Buffer Festival. So I downloaded the app so I could get my itinerary saved and everything. And yeah, we did it, guys. That was all of the apps on my phone. Wow, this has probably been way too long of a video. All right, guys, that is it for this What's on My iPhone video. I really hope that you enjoyed it and found it helpful and maybe found some new apps to try out. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did enjoy it and subscribe down below if you're new here. If you want to check out my social media and all of that fun stuff, it will be linked in the down bar. And yeah, I think that is about it. I should definitely stop talking now because my camera is flashing at me that it's dying. Yikes, I've been talking too much. But anyway, I hope that you guys are having a great day or night whenever you're watching this. I love you so much, and I will see you in my video next week. Bye.